Hey, welcome to another episode of the Yivvits and MrBubble podcast. Today is Tuesday, November 16th, 2010, and I am MrBubble.
And I be Yivvits.
Hello, Yivvits.
Hi, it's wonderful to see you again.
Oh, you too, Squire. How are you?
We have much to talk about tonight.
Ooh, come inside.
Come on in. Come on, Clegg.
We should go inside.
Okay, there we go.
There, hey.
Got the joke out.
Well, just so you know, we are friends who have many common interests.
Just like, so you know.
Like sci-fi, video games.
Oh, yeah.
And the latest Mediterranean diet tips.
Oh, you know.
Oh, man, we're just talking about that.
You know what I think? I'm going to actually, I'm just quitting the Mediterranean diet. I'm going to actually go to the raw foods movement.
Ooh, yeah.
Where everything's raw and you eat like dough or yeast balls.
Dough I can handle.
Yeast. It's basically really just yeast and then you can't cook it.
Really?
Yeah. So you can eat like, it's, I don't know,
what's
yeast
the
loaf.
What's the bottom line? I mean, what are they saying?
It's mainly like nuts and like berries and that kind of grains. That's like all you can eat.
And then what
and
happens?
No cheese. Apparently, it's really good for you. Hmm. You know? Apparently, it's great for you.
I mean, technically, Cheetos are raw, aren't they? Or are they
no, they're cooked and processed.
Okay. All right.
I mean, they really are, but I think I don't really understand the whole raw food thing. It's, come on. Just all you're going to eat is nuts and berries. Mm. And what are you, a bear or something? What?
Man, that's bullcrap about all you could eat. If you ate 4,000 calories of nuts and berries, you'd gain weight, right?
Of course you would.
You have to. Okay.
Yeah. Well, I think it's more about the processed foods and that kind of stuff that they're against. But you could at least cook the dough. What's wrong with that?
I know. We evolved to this point for a reason. I mean, we like cooked meat, right?
We like, yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, as you can see, we talk about this stuff in any of your email and voicemail, right,
David? Yes. And to talk about emails and voicemails, you have to send us some.
You have to feed us.
It's a two-way thing here. I mean, we don't just make these up to for your enjoyment.
So, yeah, here's a catchphrase. So feed us.
Feed us.
Ask us questions. Tell us what you want to talk about. Call 888-900-YAMB or send email to comments@yivvitsandmrbubble.com. What else can they do?
They can go they can go to our forums if they want. Yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Yes.
There's a Twitter, which is Twitter/YAMB, YAMB.
Yes.
There's a Facebook. I think they can do that. Maybe, what do you know about the Facebook?
Yeah, just, it's, I don't know how you tell
you
them how to
like
go.
Like us on there?
Yeah, like us. Maybe you can like us.
Like us.
Yeah.
Which I never understood. It's like, I want to join a group. I don't, you know.
Well, there are a couple kinds of groups, yeah. This one, you don't have, blah, 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 blah.
Okay.
There are like three types of Facebook groups. Learn about that on somewhere else.
But that's a different podcast.
Yeah, or just look for Yivvits on Facebook, and you'll see our group.
Yeah.
And it's kind of, people are getting into it. We've got more than 100 people who like us now.
Oh, that's good.
And I just post about an episode, and then usually people comment in that thread on there. So it's just yet another spot.
How many people don't like us?
Yeah. Thousands and thousands. Yeah, that's funny.
Thousands and thousands.
That's funny.
If we do end up having time, we might not. we'll add it to the next week list.
Okay.
Which I still haven't looked through for last week or last episode.
Oh, right,
but,
yeah.
I have some funny stats from our show.
Ooh.
That I think I normally don't really, we don't care about stats. I mean, we don't care about number of listeners and that stuff. The funny part is the distribution of some of the stats.
Okay.
So,
that'd be great.
Yeah, I gave Redheaded Tim a quiz on that yesterday, and he was quite surprised.
Really?
So,
I can't. I'm intrigued.
Yeah, like you know, most downloads from most state, or the state with the most downloads.
People will be very interested.
I have to pull it up, though.
By the end of the episode, we'll have to do that. So that'll be a teaser. So by the end of the episode, we're going to talk about what? Those kind of fun things?
Yes.
Yay.
It's very interesting.
And
so,
other surprises.
And other surprises. Did we finish everything with the contact information? I think we did. You can get our show from iTunes. You probably know that.
Yeah.
Or Zune Marketplace or Windows Mobile Marketplace. I don't know if there's anything for that.
I'm trying to figure out what exactly is that operating system. Is it Windows Phone 7? That's what I'm going
to
go with.
Windows Phone 7.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is mobile in there? Because you just said mobile.
No.
Oh,
well,
okay.
Because
I'm confused too.
Habit.
Believe me, I'm confused. So
no, it's force of habit.
But
it's a mobile.
Is it WP7, like Windows Phone 7?
I think so.
Okay. We'll get to the bottom of this because this.
We'll find out. Yes. We'll call, what's his face?
Balmer.
developers.
Windows Phone 7.
I'm just looking here if there's any old news from last week.
Oh, yes. Is there any old news?
I think there might
Nookie?
Be.
Nookie? Anything old?
Nucky, you mean?
Nucky?
Nucky? Is that
Nucky Thompson?
About?
Yes.
Nucky? He's a good actor in that. I never really liked him that
isn't
much.
Isn't he good?
He's good in that.
Steve Buscemi.
Let's see. I should disclaim, I guess, huh? We've got nothing to do with Sony Online Entertainment or LucasArts. We talk about some Star Wars stuff.
Yeah.
Or any other company that owns a trademark that we use without their permission.
Except
for Yivvits and MrBubble? What?
I don't know. I just wondered if there was one.
Except for Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Wait a minute.
You can insert it later.
We own what?
Yeah, you can insert the company later. Keep going. I'm going off the rails.
No, there's no rails.
Put your hands inside the vehicle.
Get it back on the rail.
Oh, shoot. I feel it.
Woo, that was close.
It's like an episode of Ice Truckers right there.
Oh, that's a great show.
Is it?
I've never watched it. It sounds pretty boring to me.
I have seen those Most Dangerous Road shows. Have you seen those?
No.
It's like there are some roads in other countries that are just, ugh. I mean, it's like 2,000 feet down. And there's no guardrail. That kind of thing.
True.
Oof.
I don't know. Reality shows are just, there's just too many.
Yeah.
And they're about everything. And since when is like Health Channel and Discovery Channel, it's almost all now crap that stuff. It's not about like shows that should be about animals, like, you know, when it was Steve Irwin and that kind of stuff and Jeff Corwin and those guys.
Yeah.
Now it's like, you know, Pit Boss, the pit bull, the guy who, the little guy, what's the politically correct term for midget?
I don't know.
Little person. I'm sorry if I used the wrong term, but little person. I'd be interested to know if we have any little people that listen to our show.
Maybe we do, yeah.
I mean, statistically, that's kind of interesting. I mean, that's cool.
Did you hear that story? My girlfriend told me about that story in American Life. Do you ever listen to This American Life?
Yeah, I do sometimes.
Did you hear the one kind of about, it was like people were talking about like embarrassing work stories or something?
I don't think I heard that one.
It's like this guy, I'll paraphrase it totally wrong, but it's just funny how she explains it. It's like this guy was at work and then his coworker brought her little daughter to work. That kind of thing and whatever. So he's out in the hall and he sees the little daughter. So he thinks he'll be really cool. And he like gets down and he's like, I'm a spider. I'm going to get you. And as he gets closer, he realizes it was a little person.
Oh,
oh
no.
I know. Oh, isn't that funny? No. So he has to explain to this in this corporate environment to the little person, like, hi, I thought you were a little kid. And I'm sorry. I was like a big scary spider trying to get you.
Oh, my God. That's just not right.
I love that story.
Wow. That's an awesome story.
I know. I'm sure I totally botched it, but that's the gist of it.
Oh, could you imagine?
Can you imagine like getting down and like being a spider in the hallway?
First of all, I think you could tell. I mean,
he didn't have his glasses. That makes for a beautiful story.
All right.
Makes it perfect. But yeah, he knew his coworker had her
daughter. He knew the size. He knew there was a possibility of a child being around.
Yeah, right.
I mean, it's a,
I'm a spider. I'm going to get you.
Like, that sounds like something in a movie. Oh, that's awful.
I know.
So what was I saying originally about that?
I don't know. Some of little people.
Oh, yeah. Oh, so the pit
is that,
boss.
Is that on your data chart at the end of the show? We're going to see how many little people?
No, I don't think that's in there. Okay. No, they don't provide enough feedback.
Right.
So that show, though, that I'm talking about is that it's Pit Boss. So it's a little person who was in prison, and now he's out, and he rescues pit bulls.
Oh, I mean,
is that what we're down to now?
Yay.
And what is it with their fascination with little people? I mean, I mean, if I was that, I would feel like it's like you're making me a bigger show than you need to make. You know, it's like you don't. It's like talking about something like in a nice way because you think you have to.
Oh, right,
to make
right.
somebody feel right, but then in the process of it, you end up actually talking about it so much that you're like kind of like patronizing to it.
Yeah.
You know, we got like the little chocolatiers, and I just don't get it. What's the fascination?
I have no idea.
I mean, they're people. Let them live their lives.
Yeah, I know.
I don't get it.
I don't have to say, except they all sign off on it. They all make money.
I know.
And obviously ratings are such.
Why is that a learning channel? How is that learning
blame
anything?
Blame the world, because people are unfortunately watching
it. I blame United States, actually. Yeah. I blame Americans.
Yeah.
Man, we just want the dumbest crap in the world.
I mean, with all the channels we have, I suppose that's just what you get. But man, that sucks that they cancel Caprica and they have plenty of those shows. And
they cancel Caprica, but they keep Pit Boss.
Oh, my God.
I agree.
Anyway,
they cancel real sci-fi with interconnecting plots and storylines,
real emotions,
and then they keep little people stuff. But whatever, it's ratings, blah blah blah.
Or they keep dumb shows like The Event.
Oh, I haven't watched that.
It's another one of those shows where nothing ever is resolved. Yeah, you know, in the theme of Lost.
Yeah, the vacuum exists. They have to replace it with a Lost equivalent. Yeah,
and
yeah,
just, yeah. I wanted to try to like V, but it's just, it couldn't, it did not compare even.
The
acting is just
like
not there.
Fourth grade intelligence level for V. I mean, it's the story is so, like a...
That's
scholastic
like
it, book you get
know,
at a book fair.
I don't know. I think the same people that watch V are probably the ones who went to tea parties. But, you know, I'm not sure.
No, but just for stories, I mean, V's just like a, yawn. I mean, been there.
It could be cool, but it's not. It's just, it's, meh. if we're going to bring that up, we should mention it. I guess they canceled Caprica.
Yes.
And that's kind of too bad. We both liked it.
Yeah.
I mean, it had flaws.
Of course.
It had flaws because... They didn't quite. There were times where they could have tried to advance things a little bit more.
Well,
maybe a little more sci-fi. But the redeeming factor. I'll finish quick.
Can I finish?
Yes. Redeeming quality is that it's all in that stylistic style that they did. I know it's a terrible description of it. So even if it was like a soap opera, it's in like the future in some future city. I mean. That's kind of where I'm coming from. It still had sci-fi in it, even if it didn't seem to.
Oh, yeah. Well, what pissed me off is they just stopped it. I mean,
that's just dumb.
There's still five episodes out there to watch.
Why would they not just show them?
Now, in Canada, they're still being aired week by week. Can you believe that?
Why would they not show them?
Well,
what is
the money, ratings, all that stuff, because they're only like, they said the last two episodes, like 700,000 people watched, and they get way more people for wrestling on Sci-Fi Channel now.
That's just stupid, because they don't even, it's Sci-Fi Channel.
I know.
Why is there wrestling on Sci-Fi Channel?
I know.
Isn't that... That should tell them that there's something wrong with their mechanics there.
I just want my stories. I mean, it's like a sci-fi soap opera, and there are five more episodes, and I don't want to get them through the torrents or illegally or anything like that,
well,
you know?
It's dumb. And if they should take the bullet and air them at 3 a.m. or something when, you know...
Oh, sure,
everybody DVRs them anyway.
Right.
That's partly why the numbers always look so bad. I wonder if
they factor that in now. Yeah, they can.
Do they factor that in?
They can,
because
absolutely.
They didn't originally on Battlestar, and it was dangerous for a while, but then they finally realized that so many people TiVo it. I still prefer TiVo as the term instead of DVR it.
I like TiVo. That's a good word.
Because TiVo is really the only true one out there.
Yes.
But anyway, it's just so they're and they mismanage it too. I mean, they do these weird seasons on Sci-Fi where, you know, we show four shows or no, you know, like eight shows, 10 shows, and then we wait a year.
Yeah.
And I know that there was in the Galactic of the last season, the main reason it was so long is because the writer's strike. But the fact still remains their seasons were screwy. They do that with their shows. It's like I did some form reading. I mean, they're just as bad as Fox at trying to kill a show.
Yeah, that's true.
They really are. Yeah. And they're the Sci-Fi Channel. They're supposed to be about that.
Yeah.
And half the crap that they show, I can't believe that's actually better than what Caprica was. Caprica, you know what they should do? They should take that and put it on HBO.
Yeah.
Because that's the only place that people really watch shows that actually have real thought-provoking
stuff.
There's
a good campaign going on for to keep it. I mean, people using the pound save Caprica hashtag and that kind of thing, you know, and it's out there and people talk about all the time.
I'm sure that'll work.
Yeah. They're talking, well, it worked with some shows. I mean, historically, I mean, it worked with the original Star Trek.
That
brought us the great season three of Star Trek.
But,
yes.
But, they're saying HBO, AMC, whoever does Mad Men, that one, there are a lot of networks that
Mad Men, is that TBS or EMC?
I think it's AMC. I don't know. I've never watched it.
That's popular. I've never watched it, but
it's
popular.
Oh, that guy's good looking. I know that. No, he was on Conan O'Brien, and they're always talking about how handsome he is and everything.
I did see that one, I think. Was that the first one? No.
It was the first week. I don't know.
He was also on Saturday Night Live a few weeks ago.
Have you been enjoying Conan? I love how we're talking all about TV. I love Conan.
Well, we talk about whatever.
So that's right. Right.
Oh, we got some letters here.
Yeah. But like Conan, do you remember did you watch?
I only saw the first one.
Did you see the one where they're talking to the network standards place on what they can and can't say?
No.
And that's a funny bit.
No.
But
I need to get it in my TiVo. I just completely blew it.
Oh, man.
I've been so busy.
It was just, if you like Conan, it was just.
Conan's very funny.
Oh, man.
Yep. Anyway. He's back. I
mean, he's not like going to take over the universe, but if you like Conan's quirky style, it's him.
Right. I don't think he ever wanted to take it over.
No. He just wants to be Conan. He's got a smaller crowd and. Yeah. His writers, I think, mainly went with him, so it's kind of
I really hope, though, that the show that follows him doesn't take over his slot. I mean, it's so good. So good. It just seemed really awkward. I watched the first intro part of it, and really? I was like,
ooh.
I don't have a thing against George Lopez, but he just didn't come across as a like a host of a late night talk thing. It just, I don't know, whatever.
Georgia O'Keefe.
Georgia O'Keefe. So anyway.
Anywho. Okay, well, we'll see you. That sounds great.
That's all. Yeah. Okay. Well, it was good to talk to you, Mr. Rubble.
Yeah, okay, how about, that probably was new business, but that's kind of like our going on.
My old
riff.
Business, I forgot to actually queue it up, so I can't do it this week.
All right.
But it was to get some of the old sounds from Star Wars Galaxies that were for the different planets that didn't end up in the game. Just to hear them again. I think we played them a long time ago.
All right.
But there's like three or four different planets that there are sound effects for, like, now arriving in Verona.
I remember that. You played that once. Yeah, right.
So I'll add that to the next week.
Okay.
And then we'll maybe hit it then. We'll see.
Fantastic.
We'll see.
And we'll see you later on. No.
Yeah.
We always
we'll see next week.
Yeah.
Well, one of these days.
We do have email to read. Do we have any voicemail? Anybody?
We have no voicemail because nobody cares, I guess.
Oh, my God. That's crazy.
We're just going to close that number.
Sure. We'll just transfer it to Domino's or something.
Yeah. Then they'll be sad. Because then they'll want to call, and they'll be like, oh, but we want to call you. It's like, too freaking bad you didn't do it.
Meh. So any other new business with Yivvits? You got a new cell phone today. That's exciting.
It is.
That's really exciting.
I did. Yeah, not that exciting to you.
What do you mean?
Nothing I can show you that's cool.
It's not that. I mean, I want to see it and touch it and that stuff, but what's not exciting is...
What about the cell phone, though?
Ah.
Okay, sorry.
No, keep that in. That's funny. But... Well, I mean, after a few minutes of setting up a server, when you set up another server, that's not too exciting.
Oh, it's really exciting.
Oh, well, for you,
it's exciting.
John, let me set up my second Exchange server, which I get it because that's super cool that you can. That's fantastic.
Yeah, you can't do that on an iPhone, I don't think.
I don't know. Yeah.
The only one I think you could do it on before that was the WebOS.
Yeah, Palm Pre, up to 16 server or whatever it was.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Palm.
I believe in the axiom that all politics are local. All right. I've been saying that one. I love Phil Davidson.
I believe
in the axiom.
He's a weirdo.
Phil Davidson. All right. The thing.
So you believe about WebOS.
WebOS. If I didn't have a BlackBerry, because I have them all.
Never give up your BlackBerry.
No, I won't, because I love it. I mean, I love everything about it, but... For my second choice, just to mess around with, I would love to have a WebOS for a couple months. Maybe it's a nice, really nice OS.
Like it's not bad. No,
the threading and multitasking and the UI, all that stuff is really pretty good.
Yeah, it's not bad at all.
No.
I've seen it. The devices are physically too small for my tastes.
Okay,
they're very tiny.
You're saying the Palm Pixie is
tiny little keyboard. Even the Palm Pre.
Yeah.
Had to me just this. I mean, why even have the keyboard if it's that small?
I don't know. Okay.
So that's the main. That was actually my main issue with doing this new phone, because I wanted to have a new phone, and because I'm a nerd and I need to have new stuff like that. Plus, for business, I mean, I kind of need to know other phone OSs, right?
Yeah.
So I got a Windows 7 phone, a Windows Phone 7.
Windows Mobile.
No, there's no mobile. I think it's. It's more like Zune with a phone on it, I've only plugged it in and done a couple things, so I don't really know. I got the HD 7.
Windows Phone 7 2010. Is that what it's called? Windows Mobile Phone 7 2010 2.0.
No. R2. Revision 2. Cool. No, I mean, really, come on now. It's based off of the HD 2, which is a known really good phone. I was saying to you, not that you asked me, but, you know, I like to offer up information anyway.
I wish I asked you,
Right, no. There's all this the hype about the Galaxy and all this, the huge screen and
Galaxy
stuff.
Class.
It's like they had the HD series, the HD2 had that big screen long before those other guys. Mm. So anybody that talks about them having like the best screens. Now I don't have the Super Retina, whatever the hell it is on the iPhone, but anyway, I have the spinal column on mine. Windows 7 phone, Windows Phone 7, we'll figure that out sooner or later. Well, I'll call Steve up and ask him. Yeah, I'll let everybody know how it goes.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure it'll be great. It looks like a great phone so far.
Yeah.
So, Yeah.
I just want to have something that I can message you with all the time and
yeah. Well, anything. Just because I don't have BBM.
No, but I can do anything.
I'm going to read my article, my rant article about BBM sometime on the internet.
That's fine. But because I have a BlackBerry, I can use anything you can use too, pretty much.
I can use anything.
But I mean, and so I can accommodate people that don't have BBM. I have you're the only person with Windows Live that, yes. I mean, I have Windows Live installed. I talk only to you on that. But it goes to your work machine, so I can't just send you dirty jokes and all that kind of stuff.
Well, you can.
Well, but, seriously, you say all the time your boss is like watching your stuff or what?
No, he's not watching. So it's just
hey, folks, I just want Yivvits to have like a chat client on his phone so I can talk to him.
He other wants than you texting. To have BBM. That's what he wants.
No, I just want you to have a chat thing where it's not text. That you have this nice smartphone, and I can't smartphone with you.
Well, we'll see. Yeah. We'll see what I can find out.
Now you should be able to somehow.
I don't know, but see now it's really tied in to Windows Live.
Talk or something like that.
I don't want to use Google Talk.
I know you don't. You want to have something where we can't talk.
No, I just don't want to. I have always been with everything. You go back in my history and look at my Star Wars Galaxies accounts. The way I play games, I am a one account person.
But it's stopping communications with us because if the only way I can talk to you is your corporate Windows Live Messenger or text with a 160 max character. I mean that's a frustrating world. Okay.
Oh, I agree.
We'll let the fans figure that one out.
Oh, I agree.
That was like a personal discussion almost.
Yeah, that
wasn't
was
it?
A little bit.
No, no, tell me, does this look infected to you?
Wait a minute.
Oh, anyway, what? I'll take that back
infected,
here.
Infected? What? Yeah,
I guess the answer is no. All right.
Say it again.
No.
Obi-Wan, will you look at this for Mr. Bubble? He's got something on his... He's got some kind of problem over here. Can you look at that for him?
Yes.
Obi-Wan, does this look infected?
Possibly.
Oh.
You better be careful.
Yeah, I mean, he's kind of hedging.
Go to the doctor for that.
Possibly.
What about that one over there? Look at that. That sore looks really bad, Mr. Bubble.
No, I don't think so.
No? Yeah. Not that one? No.
No, that's just a cyst. Dark Lord of the Cyst.
Oh, yeah. Dark Lord of the Cyst.
Thank you.
Of the abscess.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Okay. So, what other new business?
Yeah, I got a phone. We have some Star Wars Galaxies news today. You were telling me the other day that you were kind of having something, an itch that you couldn't get rid of.
Yes.
Just a little itch.
Yes, I often have itches.
A tingling. A tingling sensation.
So I'm inflamed, actually.
Yes. Yeah. You need Obi-Wan to look at that again?
I just want to play the game a little bit more. That's all. What do you think about that?
I think that's fine. I think that's fine.
Yes.
I'd like to, too, sometimes.
It's just I have my little ways I used to play or places I used to think that are gone or people
little,
I know are gone.
Idiosyncrasies.
Right. And I don't want to do commitments or supplies. And what's the Lando quote?
Supply problems. And
I don't have supply problems. I just want to play. I just want to play occasionally. No promises.
Yeah, you want just a casual relationship,
right?
Yeah,
with swag. Yeah.
Yes. Well, there's two sides to it, and then one side is that there's you can make it into a commitment, but then there's all the other things that can be in the game that make it a commitment. Does that make sense? Like you can sometimes turn something in yourself to a commitment.
Yeah.
But the thing we got to filter out are the things in the game that make it a commitment.
Oh, I mainly just want to play. I want to have a house that I check in occasionally and fly my spaceships.
You want to see Tweeter
and play with my droids. Yeah, just enough.
See Tweeter.
So how do you do that?
But battery
and hang out with you. I want to have you there.
Well, I mean, we could beat around the bush all day, but I think we could just say what we're going to do.
Say it.
We're going to probably move.
Yes.
Off of our server of Shadowfire.
Okay.
And we're going to probably move to the one that you probably think we're going to move to, which would be Starsider.
I think so.
So the deal is this really comes down to a matter of, because I think it's going to probably piss some people off.
Yeah.
And I am, and I know we don't have to be, but I am sorry if it does piss them off because some people followed us there.
Oh, right. And I know. I feel bad for that.
Here's the deal, though. I mean, we know that a lot of friends that we have aren't playing anymore. Right. So the number of those people that actually moved have either moved again already, or like Redheaded Tim.
Right.
Or they don't play often.
Right.
So, I'm kind of thinking the number of the possible piss-offs might not be that many.
Yeah.
But it really comes down to having fun while you play.
Yeah.
And it's just not working. We just don't think it's working for us on Shadowfire. It's nothing personal, Shatterfire. It's not you. It's us.
Yeah.
Not really.
Okay.
No, but really, I mean, it's a population thing. It's not a personal thing. And we really, I mean, we did have fun there for a little bit. And, you know, the people we met there, of course, we had fun with you guys. And you know, so I just hope that nobody is mad because we, you know. And the other thing is, people have asked us before if we're moving. And we said basically what Sony would say, which is we don't have plans right now.
Right.
But, I mean, that's the honest answer. We didn't have plans at that time. We had no plans of doing anything.
I mean, man, we talk about this game so much. We even had meetings on, like, when we started up the podcast again. We had a break there in the summer or whatever. We said, like, how do we do this show and not play the game? Because I was more adamant. I'm like, you know, I don't want to pay $15 a month for something I'm not doing and this and that. Right. But, like, the more we talk about it, it's like, and it's not like a cry for other MMOs or anything, because I have access to other MMOs. Right. I don't want to play this. But I do miss, we always talk about that open land.
Right.
I just miss having the areas where you can deploy houses anywhere.
Yeah.
And having the spaceships and flying around. And maybe there's some new duty missions and things like that.
Duty? You said duty.
No, but just having another place to hang out with friends, well, like-minded friends.
And it just comes down to people. I mean, it's just,
I can't think of anybody. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah.
No. By people, I mean population.
Ah.
It's just that's the constant issue in Star Wars Galaxies. And we had thought that maybe Shadowfire would turn out to be, you know, a great place for us. It's just, it isn't a great fit for us, for who we are. We didn't think we needed, I didn't think, I guess I'm not saying we, I didn't think that I needed that many people around to have fun.
Mm.
And I think I do now.
Yeah.
Because I just, that's like missing, you know.
That's awesome. That's good to realize that. Yeah.
So that's what's going to happen. I don't know. We don't know when it's going to happen.
No.
But
we're not going to be in a town or anything like that, are we?
No, we're not going to do a town. I don't think this time.
Okay.
Because it's just too much of a pain in the butt. Because
then when it comes,
I mean, I love
goes,
doing it, but it's just a pain in the butt to do it.
Well, if we don't have a town, we could what?
We would have a commune. A compound.
Yeah.
It'll be just like on Big Love. It'll be just like the compound.
Will it now?
Yeah, well, not quite like that. That's a different server.
Yeah,
I don't know what, but
that's in Second Life.
Yeah, that's in Second Life.
I'll bet they do have polygamy.
Oh, I'm
in
sure
Life.
That there is. Yeah,
he's got to be a polygamy.
Polygamous
island.
Compounds. Well, they had it in Caprica.
Indeed, they did.
Actually, that was
polyamory. That was
like everybody together.
Yeah, that was
like, I love you and you love me and mine loves yours and yours loves mine and we're just one big.
Right.
Big blob of human flesh.
Never know who you're going to wake up with on that show.
You never do. No.
It could be a Cylon.
Sometimes it's like a Labrador, you know, a dog. You just never know.
Anyway, I like this idea because the looser, you know, if we go OCD on this side or anal or whatever, then it's going to just derail at some point. I'm going to wake up and say, screw that.
Yeah. Well, it's nice to not have ties to it, but. Yeah. It's nice to have it just open, and we could still have like a, you know, park area, and we'll just have to make it ourselves.
Oh, yeah.
But because we wouldn't have a city hall or anything, really.
No, that's fine.
But the only thing we would never have is a shuttle.
All right.
You know what, on Starfighter, that's not even really possible.
No.
So I'm sure you can find a place that's cool, but close enough to a shuttle that is not so bad.
Yeah.
Or there's that reward thing, too, right, that you could use to land or something?
Yeah, yes. That's not going to... See, we're being anal on that one if we have to. Yeah, so that's good. That's great.
Yeah.
And we talk about, you know, the freedom of Star Wars, and that's kind of to that. So Star Sire, somewhere pretty out in the woods
we're going to be hermits to start with. That wizard's just a crazy old man.
That's very apropos. Mm. And we could pack up and move at the drop of a hat if we wanted, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we could. Okay. We'd be just like Uncle Owen.
So what else would be fun if we're fantasizing about doing this? What else would be fun?
Oh, well, for fantasizing, I mean.
Well, we're going to do it, but like in the theory of how it plays out. Because I'll probably be on there for 2 hours and be like, okay, I'm going to go play Farmville.
Yeah. Because there's so much content in Farmville.
There is.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be interesting because we haven't been anywhere where there's a lot of people for a long time.
Right.
Even on Shadowfire, when it was busy, it was never that busy.
Right.
And we met a lot of cool people. They're like Ekaway and stuff. And
everybody's got their communities. We lost our community in Valsin. The chunk of it that went to Radiant, they're still there. A lot of them are. But there's not much else on Radiant that we know. So we thought about that. But everybody I know has an alt on the big server, Star Wars.
Yeah.
So that'll be fun.
So thank you for all your fun Shadowfire, the fun that we did have, and there was fun.
And we're talking, when we're not just talking making an altar, we're talking a move in there.
Actually, right? Transfer main count, a main account tunes.
Yep.
I might leave a couple tunes behind. I don't know, but you know, I might also need them to transfer just because I've got so much junk.
Yeah, right.
So the whole city hall is full. I'll probably see if somebody wants to take over the city hall start. Yeah. I mean, you know, if some like Bogstar, you know, he's trying to help me get some more people back in there for the shuttle. Maybe he wants to take it over so you can have a shuttle there. You know, that's cool.
Oh, that's awesome.
Or Byzantius mentioned it once. I think he moved though. So
this would be so nice. I mean, just think of that, because you'll just be able to just. I mean, I'm just hoping to just get back just to playing and not really.
Yeah. Well, there's some cool things coming up that sound kind of neat. And you know, it's not like there are things that make me go, oh my God, they finally get it.
Right.
But there are things that are nice to see at this point in the game's age.
Mm.
You know? Mm. Mm. It's mature. It's it's a senior citizen.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's on Medicare.
That's good.
But it's good it's on Medicare.
Medicare's great coverage, actually.
Yeah. So, there's some cool things coming up. I'll just quickly go over. There's a producer's note for November.
Sure.
T-Squared was back in there. And for the first time ever, you'll be happy about this, Mr. Rubble.
Mm-hmm.
The Imperials are winning the battle.
Well, I heard about that.
By 2%.
Oh, that's huge.
So
that's why I'm coming back.
That's the overall galaxy score between all galaxies.
Yep. I agree. That's the whole thing, right?
That's the whole thing. Yeah,
that's about right.
Yep, they're Rebels are 49%, and the Imperials are at 51%. So I'm sure that'll go back right in our favor again pretty quick. Oh, but, you know.
Once you get back on. If you get on first, you're going to...
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I do so much content.
Right.
Let's see. He talked about some... There were some stats in here about the last event they just did. I'm not going to really read that. Life Day is coming back. There will be one kind of cool thing that is different now, and they just had that with the last event that they had too, but you're going to get some like decorations from storytellers, and they'll persist for the whole event, so you could like decorate your city for Life Day.
Or if you live in the woods, can you deploy them?
I guess you could.
See, that's cool. We'll be able to benefit for all that kind of stuff.
Yes, and they're looking at how to try to figure out how to put those big, huge trees in there without breaking the game.
Oh,
but
persistent,
Yeah. Well, they're persistent for the event.
Okay, I gotcha.
Yeah, and then they're also working on the Witches of Dathomir event, which is a content thing. You can go read about that or check it out. Part of it's in the game already. There's part of it that's there. I don't know what it is, but they're going to just at some point do some more gameplay improvements. Blah blah blah. Oh, and then there's another expansion for the trading card game.
Ah.
Now, normally that's not like anything I'm excited about,
right?
Because I don't really play it,
right?
And I don't think many other people do. At least not when I've seen them online. There's not that many people in there, but this one's actually kind of focused on Empire Strikes Back stuff.
Well, I like that
because it's 30th anniversary, you know, of that. So there's actually a lot of the loot is based off of ESB,
okay,
and a lot of the cards and stuff which you can use are based off of that. But the really cool thing is one of the houses, it's Yoda's little Dagobah house.
Oh.
Did you see? There's Yoda's. Oh, you did. Okay. Yeah. I mean, it's neat that they're going to do some ESB stuff because the game, that's the time frame the game is in. And they never do anything with it because they'd have to try to tie it into marketing for other stuff. And I don't know.
Right. Well, they're doing some. I mean, that's good. And we like Empire Strikes Back. Yeah. So, yeah.
That's not the reason we're going back. But,
you know.
I just want to play once in a while and have people around to play with.
Yeah. Now I got to move again. All the cardboard boxes. Oh, I hate all that stuff.
Yeah,
do you have a trailer? Sucks.
I don't want to do that whole thing again. I don't want to make all those loads again.
Oh, buddy.
You're going to have to... Your AB1 has its own luggage compartment,
yeah,
I think, doesn't it?
That's going to be a lot of trips, but it'll be worth it, yeah. AB1.
Take like all you can take is like a teaspoon with you each time.
Oh, basically, yeah. That's not much room left in that.
You have like a 5-gallon pail, and that's all you can take with you each time.
A 5-gallon pail of what? What would Mr. Bubble snack on?
Yeah, frosting. jelly donut glaze.
Yum, yum, yum.
Yeah, just you'd be all messy and red and sticky.
Yum.
And then we'd be like, well, that's how you always look.
Luke!
Solliston.
Yeah, anyway. I don't know where we left off here. Okay, so here's the truth, right? we paused the show for a minute because we were talking about that we're both kind of tired and we were going to like cut it short.
Right.
And
I'm tired.
And so we decided we're going to do our bit about stats because they're really interesting numbers. And we go through with the stats, and they're really cool and fun. And then I realized I never hit record. Yeah.
So it was awesome, and we had some magical things.
You wouldn't believe how fun that was.
Oh, wow.
You have no idea what you missed.
Nope.
But the reality is we're actually going to cut short this week because we just wanted to get the word out, mainly that we're thinking of moving. Well, we are moving. We'll be back next week with lots of emails and stuff. So I guess for once, this is one of those shows where we really could say we're just going to end it and then just end it.
Yep.
So maybe we should just say that, you know, like, see you later, it's been fun to see you, Mr. Rubble.
Yep.
I'll see you later. Have a good one.
Jane, I think we should get back together. It's from that movie. It's complicated. It's like
I like that movie. It was funny.
Yeah, that was okay. But I think they redubbed his voice. I mean, because every scene when what's his name? Yeah, he talks like hey,
Alec.
Yeah, Alec Baldwin.
Yeah.
Anyway,
he's big. He got big. He got fat.
Big and funny.
He is funny. Yes.
Yeah, that's really a 180 from Hunt for Red October.
Yeah.
I mean, really.
I just saw that a couple weeks ago on TV. Yeah.
I mean, it's the same guy. It's like, no, it's not.
No, it's not. It's like his older brother.
I see.
Oh, you're so funny.
Oh, very witty.
Yivvits.
Oh,
okay. Should we go on?
Yes.
It's better than what you usually start singing, like show tunes.
I don't get me started.
You know, has there ever been a Broadway musical based on Willy Wonka? It seems very obvious.
Oh, boy. Or did it go the other way? No, it was like children's book. No, I don't know. I don't know.
Wonka. There's your opportunity.
Yeah.
Wonka.
I see it. Yeah. Wonka.
Or just Charlie.
Charlie Bucket.
Charlie Bucket?
Yeah.
Bucket. Okay.
It had roots from Broadway. Like the songwriters were from Broadway.
Oh, sure. Yeah. I'm just saying it seems so obvious that they would have a Broadway musical on. I mean, it's a musical, you know, on TV.
What do you remember about that? Do you remember most things in that movie?
Yeah.
Do you remember the song "The Candyman"? Do you remember that scene in the movie?
The Candyman.
Right. Do you remember the dude in the movie? The Candyman.
Yes.
He's the guy who runs a candy shop, and all the kids after school run in there. I'm just like picturing him doing the books at the end of the month. He's like, why are we not making money? What is missing here? I don't get it. Everybody loves me. The kids love me.
I just don't make any money.
Yeah, I know. I'm just watching this thing. He's giving out all this shit.
Yeah.
You know,
it's like ripping off the thing. You know?
So you remember the little buttons.
The little buttons.
Yeah. Yep.
Buttons.
He scoops of stuff.
Which is funny candy because it's just, it's like all it is little blobs of sugar.
Yeah.
You know?
That's all candy.
I know, but
it's
still.
It's so funny. Yeah.
I mean, it's just nothing to it.
It's all forms of sugar.
Yeah.
My little wax bottles with.
I love those.
I know you do.
I love.